Hi there. So I'd like to share a mindfulness technique with you, which I found to be very helpful over the years. This comes, I think, from the room. So that's an AACA. I think that's where it comes from. Anyway, that anagram is HALT, H-A-L-T, HALT. Which stands for hungry, angry, lonely, and tired. So, if you're stressed out about something, I think originally this came from if you feel like you're having cravings. So this is very useful if you do have an addictive personality, and if you don't, I think. But I think it came from originally from if you're having cravings, i.e., if you want to use a drug, or if you feel you need to gamble, or whatever it is that's going on with you. So if you're feeling anxious, basically, then you ask yourself, am I hungry? You know, and being hungry isn't just like, oh, I get grumpy when I'm hungry. You know, there's physiological changes that happen when you're hungry. You know, your blood sugar level changes. That will alter your mood. You know, it's a fact, it's a scientific fact, it does that. So if you're feeling a bit, am I hungry? If you are, change it before you react to whatever it is that's going on. You know, do I feel angry? It's like, do you feel angry? If you feel angry, why do you feel angry? You know, what is it? Is there something? You know, it could be something going on with a work colleague or a relative or something like that. Look at what's behind that. You know, is it coming from something deeper, further back inside you? So rather than maybe putting it onto that other person, it might be, then they might behave really badly, that's fine. But just look at what's going on with you with that, again, before you react to something. Do you feel lonely? Do you feel lonely? So, you know, this can be a big thing. You know, sometimes we lash out and then there might be something happening, and you know, really there's another need inside us which needs to be met, and actually just talking to someone about what's going on, again, before you react to something, can be a really big thing. And it doesn't have to be a therapist or whatever. It could just be this person at the local shop or wherever, just to have a quick chat. And it might not even be about the thing which is stressing you out, but just to get some human contact. And the last one is tired. Are you tired? So obviously, if you're tired, sleep deprivation, you know, if you're suffering from some mental illness or some stress or addiction or whatever it is, if you're like me, if you've got small children, you don't sleep, this has a huge impact on you, on every level, on your physical level, on your emotions, everything. It's you know, it can be really draining, and it might just be, you know, you might have had a bad night last night or whatever. It might not be long-term chronic insomnia. But ask yourself, do I feel tired? Is that why I'm a bit cranky today? Is that why I'm reacting to whatever it is? So that's it. So it's H-A-L-T. So at times of stress, at times of high anxiety, when you're feeling like, oh, I don't know what to do, and ask yourself, am I hungry? If you're hungry, eat something. You know, am I angry? If you're angry, why are you angry? Is the anger directed in the direction it should be? Have a look at that. Do I feel lonely? Is there someone I can speak to? Maybe even an email or a text, you know. Better speak to someone if you can, but it's not always possible. Am I tired? You know, if you're tired, just know that you're tired. You know that you're tired and think, right, okay, I'm going to deal with this tomorrow when I've got a bit of rest or something like that. There's lots of nice techniques that can help you if you're sleeping yoga nidra and stuff like that. It can be really good. There's lots of other little techniques that you can do to have some rest during the day as well, if you can't sleep at night. So H-A-L-T, hungry, angry, lonely, tired. Keep that with you in your head, and at times of stress, just think of it, and I hope it helps you.